Mr. Sinha, thank you. Saved my life. Mr. Diwakar Manikavelu, can you also do a similar video by creating a C++ project in Visual Studio and running from Visual Studio instead of going through command line prompt? If you can do in command prompt, you can also do in Visual Studio environment. In this series of video, Vector Calculus and Classical Electromagnetism, Episode 20, Python Code in Qt Widgets, C++ Application 1. Also, in Episode 21, Call Python Program in Qt C++ Application. Watch this video. Ariel Snaplet. Brilliant. Thanks. Thank you for your message. Gabriel Bezani. Another great lesson. Nothing to say except outstanding. Thank you very much, Gabriel Bezani. I will remember your name. Great job, Professor Thomas. Thank you, Mr. Gabriel Bezani. Marvelous video. I'm learning a lot of things. Homage. I cannot forget your name, Gabriel Bezani. Carrot. Thank you very much, Mr. Carrot. I do remember your name. I try to remember names. If you remember the name, he or she comes to you special. Remembering name is very important in any serious learning as well as in human life. I will introduce a few names in this episode. Please try to remember the names I introduce in this episode. I learned I Have a Dream speech by Martin Luther King Jr. while I was in high school back in 1980s. By remembering the name Martin Luther King Jr., I learned his famous speech, I Have a Dream. I also learned John F. Kennedy's inaugural speech while in high school. At that time, I also learned another name, another Martin Luther. This Martin Luther. Martin Luther was a German born in November 10, 1483. He, Martin Luther, translated the Bible into German vernacular instead of Latin. His translation of the Bible changed the world history. I learned these things while I was in high school, back in 1980s. How can I remember these things that I learned over 30 or 40 years ago? Because I remember their names. If you remember the names, they become your permanent memory. For example, calculus of variation, Gaussian quadrature, five-point stencil. These are names that I learned while in college over 30 years ago. But I still remember them because they become part of my permanent memory. There I am. On my left-hand side, there Carrot. On my right-hand side, Gabriel Bezani. On the right-hand side. When I say Carrot on the left or Gabriel on the right, there must be some reference. Carrot is on the left with respect to I. Gabriel is on the right with respect to I am the reference. In the polled expression, the reference is peg. Peg OP polled. Three dots or ellipses is called polled. So, peg expansion is denoted with a symbol three dots or ellipses, which is called polled. Peg operator polled. The polled denoted by ellipses is on the right with respect to peg. Now, fold, operator, pack. The fold is on the left with respect to pack. In this case, we are using a single operator plus. Single in English, unary. Unary, right, fold. Unary means single operator. Right means this fold is on the right with respect to pack. In this case, single operator, so unary. This fold is on the left with respect to pack. So left, this ellipsis is called fold. So unary left fold, unary right fold. Now I open a blank file. Unary right fold, unary left fold. Unary means we are using single operator. Right fold means right fold with respect to pack. We need to enclose the fold expression. Unary means we are using single operator. Left fold means left fold with respect to pack. The pack expression must be enclosed with a parenthesis. Right fold means rightmost parameter is processed first. Left fold means leftmost parameter is processed first. Now, binary right fold. It is binary. It is binary. So we need operator, pack operator. Right fold means our pack should be here. With respect to pack, our fold is on the right. With respect to pack, here init. Now binary left fold. Binary means we need two operator. Left fold means this fold is on the left with respect to pack. Here we use init, initialization. With respect to pack, fold is on the right. We are using two operator symbols. So two means binary. With respect to pack, fold is on the right. So right fold. We are using two operator. So binary. With respect to pack, fold is on the left. So left fold. I will fix like this. Right fold means that rightmost parameter is processed first. Left fold means that leftmost parameter is processed first. Don't worry, I will give you concrete real examples. But remember four names. Unary, right fold, unary left fold, binary right fold, binary left fold. Unary, so a single operator, right fold, with respect to pack, we have to bind. Unary means single operator, left fold means fold should be on the left, with respect to pack. Binary means we are using two operator. Right fold means this fold should be on the right with respect to pack. Then we need initialization. Again, binary means we are using two operator. Left fold means this fold should be on the left with respect to pack. Then we need initialization like this. Rightmost fold means the rightmost parameter is processed first. Left fold means the leftmost parameter is processed first. Right fold means the rightmost parameter is processed first. Left fold means the leftmost parameter is processed first. If you remember the four names, you will never get confused. These fold expressions will be committed to your memory permanently. If you remember these names, the fold expressions will be committed to your memory permanently. So remember the names. To correctly and completely understand fold expression, we need to completely understand two things. One is sequenced and unsequenced. Another is evaluation order in fold expression. I will discuss evaluation order in fold expressions in my next episode. In this episode, I will discuss sequenced and unsequenced. Fire up your web browser, search for C++ Working Draft. Useful resources, c++reference.com, double-click it. Scroll down, C++ 20 Final Working Draft. Double-click this PDF. Date 2020, February 1st. Working Draft, Standard for Programming Language, C++. Click this link and download. Show in folder. If you open it, Basics, Section 9.6.9, Program Execution, Control F, Sequenced, you will find sequenced before, sequenced after. Given any two evaluation A and B, if A is sequenced before B, then the execution of A shall precede the evaluation of A. If A is not sequenced before B, and B is not sequenced before A, then A and B are unsequenced. So please remember sequenced before and unsequenced. I will explain more about sequenced and unsequenced in the near future sessions. Now, in this episode, I assume you have watched my previous episode, episode 80, Debugging C++ Type Functions at Compile Time, Paradigm Shift, Integer Sequence. If you haven't watched this video, please double-click this link. If you haven't watched my previous episode, episode 80, you may not be able to follow my current and future sessions. Show more in the download source code section, episode 80, debugging C++ type function at compile time. Please double click this link to download the source code from our previous episode. Show in folder, extract, rename it 082 sequenced. Copy the folder, paste it in your working directory. Start your Visual Studio Code, open your working folder. From folder 82, double click Shift, Ctrl B, Ctrl End. Right before function main, auto F1 stream F1 return 0, copy, paste F2, copy, paste F3. Template, type name, types, auto func, types, args, return 0, void test, order of function parameter evaluation. Here we call this func by passing f1, f2, f3, stream, and there. Now in the function main, copy this function, copy, paste, disable it. In the command prompt, cd 082 sequenced. We are using Clang compiler, SED, C++17, shift.cpp, ltbb, or c.exe, hit enter. Now we use GNU compiler, G, hit enter. CLS, using Clang compiler, we call the pung by passing the result of F1, the result of F2, the result of F3 as arguments to pung. When we built using Clang compiler, F1, F2, F3 are evaluated in declaration order. Now we are using GNU compiler. In case of GNU compiler, with this function call, F3 is evaluated, then F2, then F1. The evaluation order is different depending on compiler. This case, Clang compiler. This case, GNU compiler. Now let's try with the Microsoft compiler, cd 082 sequenced, cl ehsc sdd c++17 shift.cpp fe mm.exe, hit enter, clsm. In case of Microsoft compiler, the evaluation order of F1, F2, F3 is identical to that of GNU compiler. So let's compare. So Microsoft compiler and the Clang compiler evaluation order is different. Now one API, dir cd 082 sequenced, dp cpp q sed C++17 shift.cpp or d.exe clsd. So if we compare three compiler, Clang, GNU/G, Microsoft, Intel Data Parallel C++, in Clang compiler gives different result. That is, the evaluation order of function parameter Variable is implementation defined or unsequenced. Now let's try this void test evaluation order in an expression. Auto r equal f1 plus f2 plus f3. Copy this function, paste it here, disable it. What will be the evaluation order of f1, f2, f3? Since multiplication has precedence over addition, we can reasonably guess f2, then f3, then f1. This is our reasonable guess. I forgot stream and there. I will build again using Clang compiler, using GNU compiler, Microsoft compiler, Data Parallel CPP, CLS, Clang compiler repos, F1, F2, F3. Clang compiler repos, F1 is evaluated prior to F2, F3. GNU compiler repos, F1, F2, F3. Microsoft compiler, M, repos, F1, F2, F3. Data parallel compiler, D, repos, F1, F2, F3. So, in a pull expression, the evaluation order of individual value is executed in the declared sequence, regardless of operator. No, I just lied to you. This F1, go to definition, modifies the stream object by printing out F1 in function F2 by printing out this string. Global instance stream is modified in F3 by printing out this message. The global instance stream is modified. Go to definition. This is global object. This is called side effects. So, in function 1, we are making side effects to the global object stream. Also, we are making side effects to the global object stream. The same is true in function 3. That is, in this expression, we are making side effects in function F1, side effects in function F2, side effects in function F3. In such case, C++ standard says every value computation and the side effects associated with a pull expression is sequenced before every value computation and the side effects associated with the next pull expression to be evaluated. Because in our code, function F1, F2, F3 causes side effects. So F1, F2, F3 are sequenced, is sequenced before every value computation and the side effects associated with the next pull expression to be evaluated. Now, in clause 10, except where noted, evaluations of operands of individual operators and of sub-expression of individual expressions are unsequenced. Once again, except where noted, evaluation of operands of individual operators and of sub-expressions of individual expressions are unsequenced. That means if we disable side effects, then evaluation order can be different. Function F1, function 2 and 3 can be executed simultaneously. Once again, function F1 and function 2 and 3 can be executed simultaneously. The result of multiplication F2, F3 is added with the result of F1. Multiplication can occur simultaneously with F1 in optimized compiler. Except where noted, evaluation of operands of individual operators and of sub-expressions of expressions are unsequenced. Martin Luther translated the Bible into German vernacular. I would like to translate working draft standard for programming language C++ to layman English or Korean vernacular.